Today here at EMTB Review, I'm going to tell you about 5 tips on how to lube your bike chain. And for e-bikes, it's even more difficult and more important. All right, lubing your bike chain has always been an important task, right? Been doing this for a long time. But now that I'm testing a lot of e-bikes, I'm realizing it's even more important. Why? Because there's so much more power involved. You know, there's 3 times my leg power sustained over an hour instead of 250 watts. Now we can go 700-800 watts for an hour. So it's a lot of load on this drivetrain, this chain that wasn't really designed for this. The new stuff's coming, but you know, we're trying to make do with the existing, you know, XX1 chain that's so expensive and chain ring. And once your chain goes, your cassette and your chain ring goes as well. So it becomes like a $600-$700 cost. The other thing is you could just be going on a normal ride, but then it's a 7,000 foot ride, 30-40 mile ride because you have assist. So the rides are much longer. If you are not well lubed in the beginning, you might run out in the middle of the ride. Okay, and then for difficulty, there's a couple issues. One is you normally lube your chain like this, right? Look at that, nothing happens. So you go like that, and that's, you don't want to do that. You don't want to go around with your lube because you can't get to those rollers. The other thing is they're heavy. You know, try put this on a bike stand every day or every time you ride. It's difficult. So I'm going to tell you about the 5 tips and we'll jump right into it. The first one is get a proper bike stand. You know, and this is one of the cool bike stands. This is an Enduro Engineering. We'll have links in the description. It's cool because all you need to do is back up the bike to the front wheel slider here and then lift the rear, and then now you're good to go. Now we can be lubing away. There's a couple other tips. If you have a bike stand, you know, you just extend your dropper all the way and just hang it on the saddle. If you had to lock it, a 50-pound bike, it's a little more difficult and you'll be discouraged from doing it on a daily routine. You can also flip the bike, but you'll scratch up your saddle and your grips. And if you have a Shimano motor with a hole here still, a lot of the other motors, they don't have a hole. You could use those, what do you call that? Feedback sports, where they have a guide right here. Although it's a lot of stress on those little bars for the whole weight of the bike. Okay, so that's tip number 1, get a proper bike stand. Tip number 2, always clean your chain. Don't give it a drop of oil before you clean your chain, because all you're doing is you're gonna mix up the grime, the sand into the chain even more. So, and the best tools for cleaning your chain are these steel brushes. Don't get a plastic brush, not that park little blue brush that they had with long. Steel brush. And what you want to do is you just want to run it, clean the cassette, clean the roller, clean the pulleys, both sides. One advantage of an e-bike is there's a ratchet, so there's no dead spot, you know, right behind the crank arm. I always hate that. And then you can get behind the chainring as well. Make sure your motor is turned off, because you know, you don't want to catch your fingers, cut your fingers off when that thing catches on. Okay, so many different sizes of steel brushes is essential, and they're cheap. Harbor Freight, Amazon, get a bunch of these. Don't let the steel touch the bike, but chain, metal on metal, it's what you want. Number 3 tip is probably the best one. If you take nothing from this video, take this one away. And it is, get a bottle, like a rubberized bottle, with a metal tip. This is so key. And why is this important? It's because when I'm lubing, you've heard that adage, one drop per link, you know, and then you're good, and then maybe go around it a second time. That's, to me, that's BS. You're wasting lube. You're wasting lube. You know, forever I mess up the floor. Anything, any lube on the floor is wasted. So, you know, that's not ideal. But then you want to be insured that the chain is lubed. And really what you're lubing is the roller, not the sides, not the plates, the roller inside. That's what's taking up all the force transferring from here to here. So the metal tip, look at that, it doesn't even drop. What you could do is you could just place it like right there, right on top of the roller, and you don't need to touch the roller. You just spin, and this really just takes 3 revolutions, and then you get the stream going. So I hope to get this on close up, but you get the stream going, and this works so well. I'm using ProLink, by the way, a light lube for the California conditions. You get it so well that every roller is lubricated completely. Very few drops hit the floor. There's not a lot of need for wiping. This is the best. This is really the impetus for this video. If I want to spread the word, you know, about the this technique. All right, the number 4 tip goes hand in hand with my little bottle technique, is you buy lube in big containers. I don't know how big this is, many ounces. Get your lube in big containers like this, because lube is kind of a ripoff. $10 a bottle, $15 a bottle, and then most of it goes to the floor. Just get a big one like this. You refill this countless times. You know, this is about the, you know, a little more than this is what I use for one bike. So it's so economical, and you just need to transfer this bottle into here. It's kind of tricky. I use either a little funnel or an air bulb right here. Works really well. All right, the number 5 tip, and I thought of another one, so I'll give you a bonus, is you can use an Allen hex wrench or a Torx into some of your chain rings. So a lot of them, especially I think the SRAM, you can stick this into the screw hole, and then you can backpedal. So backpedaling, then you need a fancy stand like this. In my situation, I do forward pedal while I'm cleaning and backpedal, and that's really effective. So, and there's even tools that you can buy that take the place of this. This is not ideal because it doesn't work for everything. Like the Shimano doesn't work for that. And sometimes it gets stuck even on the SRAM. So less than ideal, but pretty good tool, and a lot of my friends use this. My last tip for you guys, don't be lubing at the parking lot and then get up and go. Ideally, just do this after you wash your bike. Do it the night before. Do it right after you get home, after you clean your bike, clean your chain, and then lube it. And then so when you ride it, 1 day later, 2 days later, it's perfectly soaked in. And what you're really looking for, like I said, is the roller. The roller is the one that takes the most stress. And in my technique, really, I'm pedaling like this. It's kind of stiff after it's clean. As I do the lube, it gets freer. I really see the difference after I've put in a good lube. So there you go. I hope you found that helpful. Advice for e-bikes, advice for normal bikes as well. Just don't let your chain go dry on you, because it really stretches it out. And once it stretches, it'll stretch your cassette, it'll stretch your chain ring, your drivetrain is toast. And you know, we're living on borrowed time with e-bikes and all these old drivetrains. So we gotta preserve what we have, you know, keeping them clean and keeping them perfectly lubed until the stronger, you know, more robust stuff comes out. Thanks a ton.